Hi guys and welcome back in MedicalScribe. This video is the second video in the Introduction to Anatomy series. And today we will talk about the first approach in studying anatomy, which is the regional anatomy. And this is the first part in this approach. The regional anatomy, from its name, we can expect that we will study the human body by regions. That means we will divide the body into many regions and every region will be studied completely, including study of the skin, muscles, bones, nerves, organs, and everything exists in that region. Alright, after we knew the meaning of the regional anatomy, we will see now for how many regions the human body will be divided. Firstly, let's agree all that we will see many methods in dividing the human body. For example, it may divide into axial and appendicular, or it may be divided into systems, or maybe into parts. But I'm saying that there is a lot of methods to divide the body. But it not mean that one way is true while the other is false. No. All these methods will be used at a particular time, because it will serve us in that time and make us able to describe what we have to describe clearly to the others. So keep in mind that you will face a lot of divisions. Don't be confused of which is true and which one we have to follow. Most of them are true and we will use them in their place. Alright? Okay. So in the regional anatomy, we will divide the human body for 5 major parts. May someone ask me, why not 6? Or why not 4? Why it 5 exactly? Honestly, I don't found a reference clarify this reason. But I think that because every part has its own differences from the others, either structurally or functionally. So, we can't merge 2 of them in one part. That will not work. So, I think that is the logical reason for that. And if anyone have a trusted reason, I would thankful to write it down in the comments section and I'll pin it for others. So these 5 parts are the head, neck, trunk, upper limbs, and the lower limbs. So these are the major parts of the human body. I'd not to miss that the trunk further subdivided into some parts, which are the thorax, abdomen, back, pelvis with perineum together. Okay? Good. But we will face another problem when we will study the head, for example. The problem is that the head or any part is huge in details to study at one time. Because you know there's a lot of muscles, bones, nerves, vessels, and so on. So, they say that in order to study every major part easier, we will further divide the major parts into areas and regions. Like in the head, for example, we will focusing on a specific area when we will study, like on the face, for example, or focusing on a particular region like the orbital region. And suppose that we will focus on the orbital region. We will study here all the structures, relations, arrangements between the muscles, nerves, vessels, and anything will exist here. After that, we will move to study the nearest region in an ordered sequential manner. And we make that process in order to correlate the information between the 2 regions together. And should keep in mind that routinely, we have to put the region under study into the context of the adjacent regions, and also into the context of the body as a whole. Finally, the study of any region in the regional anatomy approach will be in layers organization. What I mean, we will begin by the skin, then descend to the subcutaneous tissue which is under the skin, then to the deep fascia that cover the deeper structures like muscles, bones, and cavities. And the cavities contain the viscera or the internal organ. So this is the methodology of a study in regional anatomy approach. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you in the second part of regional anatomy, and goodbye.